The Out of Bounds Show podcast is brought to you by Boar's Head, premium meats, cheeses, and hummus. Boar's Head, compromise elsewhere.
WRKS Pickens Jackson.
All systems go.
Live from the Whiskey 61 Lounge inside the BankPlus Studio.
This is our warning.
Live in the studio.
It's the Out of Bounds Show with Bo Bounds.
Streaming live worldwide on the Out of Bounds radio app.
And on your radio at ESPN 105.9.
All set? Let's go.
The Zone.
All right, good morning. Welcome in to the Out of Bounds Show, 105.9 The Zone, WRKS. We are powered by Dancing Rabbit Golf Club and the Golden Moon Casino Sportsbook. If you bet $50 there, you can play award-winning Dancing Rabbit Golf Club for $25. Hit up dancingrabbitgolf.com, dancingrabbitgolf.com. We're streaming live on the Out of Bounds radio app and the zone1059.com. Wild night in sports for the Florida Gators and Texas Longhorns. Wow, we'll have to get into that. Farm Bureau Insurance call in line 601-707-3750. Twitter handle at Bowbounds, and you can hit us up on the Ag Up Equipment text line 601-885-3776, 885-3776. I've got Blake with me. I'm your host, Bowbounds. We'll have Mike Dettillier at 8:30, and then Jake Mangum, the Hit King, will join us live in the Bank Plus studio from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m., and we'll catch up on everything that he's doing and his thoughts on Will Rogers and that Mississippi State football team too. So Jake Mangum, the Hit King, will join us at 9 a.m. in the Bank Plus studio. You can watch it on YouTube, search Out of Bounds Sports. You can watch it on Facebook, search the Out of Bounds Show. Blake, should we give away at some point an autographed baseball from Jake Mangum?
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay.
I love giving away stuff.
Yeah.
It's one of my favorite things to do. I just like to make people happy.
You like, is that what you like?
I love it. I really do.
Well, Dan Mullen did not make the Florida Gator fan base happy.
He's giving away advice, but it may not be the right advice.
May not be the right advice. All right. So let's set this up. Dan Mullen is under some heat. And with the Florida Gator fan base, and he has lost to Alabama, Georgia, Kentucky, and LSU. And he's only minus one coach effect. That may throw some people off. Because he lost to Bama, and according to where they recruit, that's not a minus one. And he lost to Georgia on a neutral field, and how they recruit, that's not a minus one. And he lost to LSU at LSU. And they're a top. So he's lost to three top five recruiters. And he lost at Kentucky. And the fan base is losing their mind. And they were just blown out by, well, I guess their rival, Blake?
They're definitely their rival. The only thing standing between them and Atlanta.
They were in Atlanta last year.
Yeah.
And their last two games against Alabama had been fairly close games.
Yeah, competitive.
But Georgia blew their doors off.
They did.
In the cocktail party on Saturday. And we're about to drop some audio. This is what Dan Mullen had to say when he was asked about recruiting.
Coach, the topic of recruiting has come up a lot the last couple of days from a few angles. Is it a different approach needed for the level of consistency?
Well, we're in the season right now. We'll do recruiting after the season. When it gets this recruiting time, we can talk about recruiting.
Sounds good.
Okay. Next question.
Whoa. All right, so those are bad optics. Some would say terrible optics. Bad PR move. Sometimes you just need to tell your fan base what they want to hear.
Honey, do I look fat in this dress?
Absolutely not.
Yeah. Yeah.
Absolutely not. You know? And sometimes you just need to tell, and this is anything in life, sometimes you just need to tell someone around you what they want to hear.
Yep.
Which is where Blake was going.
Yep.
But there are times when you just need to tell your fan base what they want to, you know what? And so you could have said, look, hey, our goal is to continue to upgrade the talent on our roster. We're working 24/7 to do that. We added two super recruiters in Tim Brewster and Wesley Crime Dog McGriff. We're continuing to evaluate everything we're doing. We're excited, whether he is or not, we're excited about the class that we're recruiting. We plan on finishing strong. That's it.
And none of that means anything.
No, it means nothing. No. but Gator 2947 on the message board feels better.
Yeah. No, 100%.
Okay.
100%.
You know, the guy that has 8 club level seats,
yep,
and spends $15,000 a year, that's before, you know, tailgating and hotel rooms and all the other stuff, and a lot of times in after tax. He's like, oh, I feel bad. Dan's working on it, guys. He's working on it. And Anthony Richardson's coming back.
Yep.
And he's done this before at other programs. Oh, okay. You know, where he's had a guy that looked like he had potential, big, strong, physical, and all of a sudden things turn around. But instead, you tell the fan base exactly what they don't want to hear. Do we have the Kirby Smart audio?
Yeah.
So his rival coach in the East, because the East is terrible. And by the way, Dan's playing South Carolina this weekend, right? At South Carolina. So he's facing off against Shane Beamer, the next Urban Meyer. Here is Kirby Smart talking about recruiting.
Guys, if you don't recruit, there's no coach out there that can out-coach recruiting, okay? I don't care who you are. The best coach to ever play the game better be a good recruiter, because no coaching is going to out-coach players. I mean, anybody will tell you our defense is good because they got good players. So spending time on the phone, you know, spending time with people at your house, spending time with people when they come to your campus. You know, I'm not with my family when I'm doing that. My family sacrifices so that I can go and spend time with other people's families so that we have good players. So, you know, that's 25% evaluation. That's 50% recruiting. And another 25% is going to be coaching. But if you don't recruit, guys, you got no chance. Just go look. Look at the best teams out there. They got good football players. And that's the reason I believe in recruiting. And I believe you better always be recruiting. Always be recruiting. Because if you're not, somebody else is.
The oven went from about 600 degrees to 1,200 degrees after that.
You think Kirby's wife goes, man, I wish he'd talk about me that way.
Yeah. Well, and don't get me wrong. That's a $7.7 million a year. His family misses him.
Look.
I
do wonder if sometimes he ought to go to maybe 35% coaching and try to fix some of that stuff they got going on offense.
He may be able to pull how poorly he has recruited at quarterback. He has recruited as poorly as you can, yeah, as a blue blood.
Yeah.
He may be able to pull off winning a national title, recruiting great everywhere
except
quarterback, yeah, with Stetson Bennett IV or JT Daniels. Who knows? I mean, if they get past Bama, there may not be anybody left that can, because the college football is weak. It's down, but it could be more exciting. But then again, maybe it will not be. Maybe Georgia
just walks.
If Georgia gets through Bama, and I do think Bama is capable of beating them, but if Georgia gets through Bama, maybe they walk through the semifinal and finals, Blake, against Ohio State, maybe Oregon gets in because Bama's eliminated.
Undefeated Wake Forest.
Bar 2 says that Wake Forest should be ranked ahead of Oklahoma in the college football playoff rankings tonight. And if they're not, they're going against what they've done the last 49 rankings. We'll see. Big board coming up next. Dan Mullins in some hot water. And we've got a monkey and an exotic dancer with the Texas Longhorns.
The Out of Bounds Show podcast is powered by Breezy Oaks Ranch. For Mississippi-raised premium Wagyu beef and heritage pork shipped straight to your door, visit BreezyOaksRanch.com.
On the Big Board.
That's funny. I didn't see those guys at the game. Watching the, we had the Ole Miss Auburn game on yesterday morning, and we have the Mississippi State Kentucky game on today.
Isn't technology great?
It is.
I think you used to have to put a VHS into a VCR and like record that sucker for 3 hours just to be able to watch something back. Now we can just dial up any game in the country. Pretty much. It takes 2 minutes.
Isn't that crazy?
It's awesome.
Right now it's 10-7, Kentucky over Mississippi State. 5 minutes and 47 seconds left to go in the second quarter.
Dude, can we talk about...
I just thought I'd give y'all an update.
Something that was really almost bad.
Although they're about to score.
Mississippi State stops Kentucky and calls timeout with like minute 30 or whatever on the clock to get the ball back.
Uh-huh.
And what do they do? Something that they have struggled with, it feels like, the last 5 years. Fielding punts. You don't field the punt. The ball goes down to the 2-yard line, and you almost give Kentucky a walk-in touchdown to change the momentum of the game before halftime.
Yeah.
What is it with not catching the ball? Catch the ball. What are you doing?
Yeah. I'm with you, man.
I thought that was going to be a monster shift in the game right there.
Sure.
Because you were either going to give up a safety or a defensive touchdown. Or what you did give up was a short field that luckily your defense got a tip pass interception on.
Did that Jaden Wally, did that count as a rush?
I didn't see it. I'm sorry.
Okay. I didn't think I saw it on the stat sheet, but I had to go back and look.
If it was a sweep and he touched past it from the quarterback, it's a pass.
I looked down for a second.
Flick it.
And I don't know if he threw it in front of him.
Yeah,
he may have.
He probably touched past it in front of him.
All right, cool. All right, well, we're watching the game, and I know you're thrilled that we're talking about it.
There you go.
Out of Bounds, 105.9 The Zone, ESPN, the Big Board, is brought to you by Superior Foundation for all your foundation repairs and Dallas Body Shop in Ridgeland. Dallas Body Shop for all your collision repair. And Edwin Watts Golf Shop on County Line Road before you hit Live Oaks Golf Club. So, big story, Dan Mullen getting snarky with the media. And Florida maybe shutting it down all week with the media.
It's not looking good.
After Dan really dropped the ball, he was asked about recruiting. And he just... Man, again, tell your fan base what they want to hear every now and then. Actually, I'd do it more than that, but at least every now and then, tell them what they want to hear. You know, our goal is to continue to upgrade the talent on the roster. We're working 24/7 to do that, and we believe in where we're going and what we're doing. And sell Anthony Richardson and da-da-da-da-da. Instead, terrible optics from Dan Mullen, who's only minus one coach effect, but you kind of feel like he's like minus four coach effect.
In reality, he's minus two. I will argue till my deathbed that you have to take into consideration midseason changes. LSU, the team he lost, the LSU team that they lost to, should never in 10 tries beat a decent team. That was a loss of all losses for Dan Mullen.
Is it an abomination for you?
I mean, your quarterback's throwing all those intercepts. I get it. Like, the coach doesn't throw the ball, but you got to have a better plan. You got to have an adjustment, something. And you can't stop two run plays. That's a minus one. So I'm giving him a minus two on the out of bounds rating.
Now, Bruce Feldman has never liked Dan. He's taken shots like crazy on theathletic.com. Title of that article is Florida. They just don't play hard. College football coaches on the growing gap between Florida and Georgia. Now, just last year, Blake, Dan beat Georgia.
Oh, yeah.
This year, he lost. They got blown out 34-7. And now, this is the third article from theathletic.com. Bruce Feldman, Andy Staples, and is it Ari? Yeah, Ari Wasserman.
I believe that's correct, yeah.
All have dropped articles on Dan Mullen. Wasserman's article, the title is Dan Mullen Doesn't Get It, which means Florida has a problem. And then Andy Staples' title is Dan Mullen's Actions Show He Doesn't Understand the Job Requirement at Florida. And we just went over Bruce Feldman. And old Bruce, now, Bruce probably called an offensive analyst at South Carolina and the running backs coach at Kentucky to get some scathing quotes for this article because he references several
SEC coaches.
Yeah, if you will. But in here it says Florida, they just don't play hard. Georgia's trying to rip your head off. They might be up 30-0, and their linebackers are flying up the field to get after your blank. Florida is a finesse team. Kentucky plays hard. You watch UF on tape, they've got skill, but they're not physical.
Ooh.
Another SEC coach whose team faced the Gators this season, they play with zero, which means it's, you would think it's Kentucky. Maybe Tennessee, bitter about the loss. We're more physical. No, I'm sorry. Let me go up a spot. They play with zero discipline. They don't play hard. I guess it could be a Bama offensive analyst or defensive analyst too. Who knows? But Bruce was on the phone with assistant coaches or offensive and defensive analysts that have faced the Florida Gators this year. Another SEC defensive coach wondered, and I quote, "What in the world are they trying to get done?" The unit ranked 74th in points allowed, 83rd in total defense, and 85th in yards per play allowed. He went on to say last year they were doing some really unsound things defensively. They just do some crazy, goofy things. They're odd. Another SEC offensive coach. We thought going in that it was going to be one of the best defenses we face, but they just weren't physical. They don't look motivated, not fired up, no juice. Schematically, they make no adjustments on defense. They have no answers. They'll stay in a two-high shell as long as they can. They walk Jeremiah Moon down to create a five-man front and think that they can stop the run with just that, but they can't. That may be an LSU staffer.
Hello. Sounded like you were describing the last decade of Texas football.
Oh, should we get into that?
I mean, I just what you said was talented but soft.
So Jeff Banks has made the news. Nobody listening knows who he is. He's the special teams coordinator for the University of Texas. And he has made the news because a story is broke that his new wife, whose nickname is Pole Assassin, she's an exotic dancer, you can figure out that. She also dances with at least one monkey on stage.
Correct.
Which is whatever. He left his wife and kids for this exotic dancer. All right, again, he's the University of Texas special teams coordinator. And he makes over $1 million a year. And evidently they had a Halloween party, and the monkey bit a kid, and they had to pull the monkey off of the kid. And the story has now gone viral, and Pole Assassin, who is his wife, and I guess this is all maybe allegedly, decided to tweet all the way through it, which was great for Jeff Banks' career.
Guess and, what? Texas still sucks.
Well, maybe not at trick-or-treating, okay? And so that's the big thing going on at Texas, and can you imagine what Steve Sarkisian's text messages look like? you know, the back and forth that he's gone through with who knows who. So that's going on in Texas. And then Merlin's is in some hot water. Some of you think it's bowling in Gainesville. We're live in the Bank Plus studio. SEC Insider Hit next. The Out of Bounds Show podcast is presented by Edwin Watts Golf Shop on County Line Road. Your golf game starts with Edwin Watts Golf Shop.
Do it.
This is the SEC Insider Hit. And it's presented by Blue Cross Blue Shield of Mississippi. It's good to be blue.
Man, we talking analytics. Oh, wait. We've had Bar 2 on for 11 years. We were doing analytics before anybody else. Live in the Bank Plus studio. Out of bounds. 105.9 The Zone ESPN. Powered by Edwin Watts Golf Shop on County Line Road. Edwin Watts Golf Shop. Carrie and the crew. I think Carrie was at the Atlanta Braves game over the weekend. Can't believe he didn't call me for the invite. I'd have bought him lunch or dinner at Murph's. Dale Murphy's restaurant and bar. Let's check that out. 105.9 The Zone ESPN. I know Pete Lavin was there. Mississippi Braves general manager. Good for him, too. And Chris Harris, both with the M-Braves. Awesome that the Braves invited their minor league dudes to share that experience. And we've got Game 6, according to Blake Mania. Game 6 tonight, Braves at the Astros. Game 6, Atlanta's up 3-2, Blake Mania.
That's right.
Okay.
Go Braves.
Go Braves. I like the Astros. I love our Houston Astros hat that we actually have in studio right now that Roy Oswalt signed. Should we give that away or should we hang on to that?
We should hang on to it.
Okay, we're giving away a Jake Mangum baseball this morning?
Yes.
Okay. All right. Should we just kind of tee it up as weigh in on any of the topics that we hit?
Yeah.
And we pick the best text in the next 30 minutes?
Let's do it. That's
okay.
Easy.
Jake Mangum, signed baseball, best text on the Ag Up equipment text line. I'm about to give it to you. 601-885-3776. We're about to get into Lane Kiffin, but we mentioned Dan Mullen. Terrible, terrible, terrible optics PR from Dan Mullen. He's in hot, 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 hot water with the fan base. Actually, he made it worse than it is.
Exactly.
Again, terrible optics sold.
Is that surprising?
A lot of times you just got to tell people what they want to hear, and a lot of times. I don't care if you're a high school coach, college coach, even NFL. You need to tell the fan base what they want to hear. Would have been easy. Guys, we're working night and day to recruit. We're focused on this 2022 class. We're excited about it. Anthony Richardson, we believe we've got a great young quarterback, whatever. And we're locked in. My assistant coaches are locked in, and we think we're going to finish strong. That's it, Blake. And like I said earlier, Gator 5815 on the message board is happier. He has 4 seats on the 30-yard line. They mean a lot to him, as they should. He drives in from Ocala, Florida, 5 to 6 times a year, and he wears jorts and a tank top,
yep,
and he cheers on his Florida Gators, and he just needed Dan Mullen to say, we're locked in on recruiting and getting better and upgrading the roster.
But even if Dan says that, he'll never sound as passionate as Kirby Smart did talking about
it. Okay, well, we're going to drop all that. We got a lot of audio. We got 24 straight minutes right now without a break. That's what we do at 7:30, 8:30, and 9:30. We do that for the listeners, and I like that you brought that up. Do you want to go with that first?
We can go wherever you want to.
And do Lane later at like 7:45?
You already started the Dan train, so let's
stay
on it.
All right, fine.
It's hot. It's a hot topic.
We'll do the Lane Kiffin audio, which is really good.
Yeah.
At 7:45-ish.
We'll get there.
All right, here we go. The SEC Insider Hit this morning is brought to you by Blue Cross Blue Shield of Mississippi. It's good to be blue. The official healthcare provider of the Out of Bounds Show. Blue Cross, Blue Shield of Mississippi. All right, here we go. Dan Mullen's in hot water after a recruiting. He was asked about recruiting. And then Kirby counters, but we're not going to go back-to-back. We'll drop Dan's comments first. Here's Dan Mullen.
Coach, the topic of recruiting has come up a lot the last couple of days from a few angles. Is it a different approach needed for the level of consistency?
Well, we're in the season right now. We'll do recruiting after the season. And when it gets this recruiting time, we can talk about recruiting.
Sounds good.
Okay. Next question.
The next question is really the worst, like the dismissive next question. It's a bad look.
Yeah.
It means you're sensitive, right?
Yes.
Only sensitive people. You only do that when you're talking about a sore subject.
Right. All right. I do want to let you know this, that Florida, and this may surprise some of y'all. I don't know. It may not. But just because we've been in the business for 20 years, we've talked to 9,000 people just like you have in your industry. And, you know, we're always learning about what's going on. And we've made contacts all over the SEC, but also all over the country. I just want you to know this. Florida will never, ever, ever, ever throw down in the street like Georgia and Bama and LSU, like Kirby, Saban, and Smart. Yes, I know about Urban Meyer's two recruiting classes that were through the roof, off the charts, unbelievable. I do. I know about them. Florida, when I tell you they take pride in their academic, their top 10 public university academically, and their research and so on, they will never throw down. They will not pay $100,000+ for players. A player. That's what they're doing. I mean, when you see on signing day it go down to the wire, like Smart and Saban on a kid, I'm just going to go an edge rusher out of Atlanta. That guy's going for $100,000+. Left tackle, $100,000+.
Yeah.
Okay. A lot of times a WR1, $100,000+. An interior defensive lineman. Okay. So that's not – Steve Spurrier did not do that. Now, Urban landed two classes. I'd have to do a deeper dive on exactly who his lead recruiters were, but he was a maniac on recruiting and whatever. This is Kirby Smart talking about recruiting, and he doesn't just take a shot at Dan. He goes in for the kill.
Guys, if you don't recruit, there's no coach out there that can out-coach recruiting. Okay? I don't care who you are. The best coach to ever play the game better be a good recruiter, because no coaching is going to out coach players. I mean, anybody will tell you our defense is good because they got good players. So spending time on the phone, you know, spending time with people at your house, spending time with people when they come to your campus. You know, I'm not with my family when I'm doing that. My family sacrifices so that I can go and spend time with other people's families so that we have good players. So, you know, that's 25% evaluation. That's 50% recruiting, and another 25% is going to be coaching. But if you don't recruit, guys, you got no chance. Just go look. Look at the best teams out there. They got good football players. And that's the reason I believe in recruiting, and I believe you better always be recruiting. Always be recruiting, because if you're not, somebody else is.
All right, so Kirby Smart goes for the kill in the counter. To Dan Mullen, because guess what? Kirby, believe it or not, I know he just beat him 34-7. He wants Dan out of Gainesville. He'd much rather have a McElwain, Muschamp, Ron Zook type guy. Now, the Farm Bureau Insurance call-in line is 601-707-3750. 601-707-3750. Brought to you by Farm Bureau Insurance. Bundle your auto and home and save with your local Farm Bureau insurance agent in any of the 82 counties in the great state of Mississippi. Now, we're streaming live on the Out of Bounds radio app, and Kirby just talked about sacrifice. It's a $7.7 million sacrifice for his family annually, because that's somewhere in the ballpark as to what Kirby Smart makes. Now, Kirby is an animal on the recruiting trail, except at quarterback.
Well, it's because he doesn't understand the position.
He doesn't understand the position nor offense. And so they may pull this off this year. For the first time since Ronald Reagan's first year in office, 1980, Georgia may win a national title with either Stetson Bennett IV, Mr. Ranch Dressing, which maybe he'll win the Heisman, or JT Daniels. But the bottom line is, Georgia is awesome all the way across the board, except they can't recruit quarterbacks. I guess because a lot of them can't be bought. I don't know. But
or just that he's buying the wrong ones.
Maybe that's, so.
I mean, they signed that Dwayne Mathis kid who was a 5-star, and then he looked like he'd never held a football before.
That's a good point. You know. So they may, because college football is so weird this year, they may be able to pull this off. If they beat Bama in the SEC championship game, and again, I think Bama can beat them too. I expect unless something weird happens, I expect a very, very competitive game. If we get that, if Auburn, where is Auburn? Are they at two losses, and would they win the tiebreaker if they beat the Bammers?
Well, Auburn is at two losses, but only one's in conference. It's Georgia.
Penn State.
The other one's Penn State.
Okay, so Auburn's could do this, but if Bama makes Atlanta, They could beat Georgia, but here's the deal, guys. If Georgia beats Bama or whoever, Auburn, in the SEC championship game, I'm not sure anybody, I mean, is there anybody out there that can really test them? They have the best unit in the country. That's their defensive unit. And then on offense, they're good. And that's with a walk-on that probably should be Blake at College of Charleston. I don't even know if they play football, but you know what I mean. Wofford. I mean, Stetson Bennett the fourth is the perfect quarterback to start at Swanee or Wofford.
Yes.
Right?
Correct.
Okay. All right.
I think the team that could challenge Georgia in the playoff is Ohio State.
Do you?
Because their defense, their metrics have been on a straight climb since week one.
Okay.
They've gotten better defensively.
And maybe C.J. Stroud can score just enough.
There's no doubt C.J. Stroud is playing better football. I mean, the kid had never thrown a pass in college when they started this season. So it was probably naive of us to assume that he was going to walk out and be Justin Fields, right? That's not how that works. So.
All right. But now you just said something during the break, that when you watch Kirby in that video.
Yes. We just
talking about recruiting.
Yep.
And how locked in he is and how passionate he is, it's almost like Kirby would rather be recruiting than coaching.
Correct.
Like, the idea of big game hunting, which he does against, more so against Saban than anybody else, but he has to compete against Dabo, Ogeron, or whoever LSU names, and probably Jimbo. And Jimbo will throw, I mean, this is not hard to figure out. These guys are all under the Saban tree, right? Jimbo will throw down in the street with the best of them. And he's come over here and you know, signed the number one player in the state. And everybody just sat on their hands, which is incredible. Kirby did the year before. He came over here, signed the number one player in the state in N'Kobe Dean.
He's balling out.
He
right
is.
Now. Good Lord.
Pick six on Saturday, right?
Yep.
He ran that in.
Yep.
And so they don't care where they have to go. They'll come in your state, drop whatever they do, whatever deal they have to do to get that player. And so Kirby, like, you could almost tell he was like, no, I recruit.
The reason Kirby loves
recruiting, that's what I do.
The reason he loves recruiting so much is, where is the one area where he can compete against anyone in the country?
It's
recruiting.
Right.
And coaches love two things. They love to win, but they love to control how they win.
And he loves beating Saban.
Correct.
And he loves beating everybody, but he and Saban, let's just say they probably almost split with all the fours and fives they've gone,
it's
right?
Probably accurate,
but they've had some major battles that have gone down to signing day, 1-2 o'clock in the afternoon, deals still trying to get done behind the scenes, and so on, right? Counter, whatever. And so Kirby may pull this off. He's absolutely and totally inept at recruiting the QB position. But they are stocked full of talent. Blake, just about everywhere else, but they are nasty on deep. They're like Bama was in 2010.
Yeah.
And we were not sure that we would get another defense like that.
It's been impressive how well they've played.
For a while.
Now, the one caveat.
Now, Dan, all right, I want y'all to know that the last 21 years, Florida is a 9.8 composite recruiter, okay? So, and where is Dan recruiting? Right there. So when people say, well, Mullen's not recruiting, well, he's not recruiting like Kirby and Saban, because if you look at, which I'm looking at right now, If you look at the 247 sports rankings, there is a massive drop-off after the top two.
Yep.
After Georgia and Bama, there is a big, big drop. And if you notice, there's not even a point separating Georgia at number one and Bama at number two. You can do with that what you want. I'm just telling you what the numbers are.
The problem is in the last, what is it, like 8 years, you haven't had a team with that low of a composite win the title except for Clemson.
Except Clemson with a great quarterback and obviously a really top-notch defensive coordinator. Yeah. You're right. And Auburn did it. So there's only been two teams that have been able to pull it off, and that's Clemson with Deshaun Watson, who was a great college quarterback, and Auburn with Cam Newton, who was a great college quarterback.
And that was a different league 11 years ago.
Right.
Not even
But it happened
game.
In the 2000s, yeah. And the bottom line is those are the two non-elite recruiters to win national championships.
And they're still pretty elite recruit. I mean, in the grand scheme of things, they're still top 15
they're
recruiters.
Still absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. So that's where we are. Mullen's under fire, and he decided to go ahead and pour some gasoline like on the fire around him, and by being super snarky and, you know, yeah, with
you just
some
have
reporter.
To show a different level
just
of
tell
standard.
The fan base what they want to hear.
Yeah, when you're at, he could have gotten away with that a little bit at Mississippi State, because by the time he had the credit, like, he had done enough 3-4 years in that he had some chips on the table. At Florida, it doesn't work that way. Every year, you got to build new chips, basically.
Right. And Florida's going to have to pull this off. They're never going to... I just don't ever see them as a top three recruiter, regardless of who they have in there. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe they hire... well, I don't know. I don't know who that would be, but we'll have to think that through. But Dan will get next year. He should win the next four games. Blake said he could lose to Florida State earlier this morning when we were doing a little prep. But he plays at South Carolina. They're terrible. Samford at Missouri. They're not good. And then Florida State at home. Florida State's trying to show a little life. All right, let's switch gears to the Lane Kiffin SEC shorts. This guy... Were you with me the night that we had dinner at...
I met him, but I wasn't able to stay that day.
Okay.
But I did meet him.
All right, so the SEC shorts guys, they throw out all these funny videos mocking and having fun with coaches and fan bases. And the two guys are from Alabama. I think one's Bama, one's Auburn. The one that did this is the Auburn guy. And they were over at Gold Moon Casino Sportsbook and Philip M's a year or so ago, and we all went to dinner, and they had us rolling the whole time. They did what they call their video production, Blake,
yeah,
is SEC Shorts.
Yep.
And so they do them every week, and they're great, and they've got some big-time sponsors and so on. So they did one on Lane Kiffin, and this is Lane Kiffin with a devil on one shoulder and an angel on the other, talking to Lane about analytics. It is so good. So hopefully you can envision. All right, Lane's in the middle. You got a devil on the left shoulder and an angel on the right shoulder, and they're debating analytics and going for it on fourth down.
Yeah.
So here it is. Good morning. Welcome in. Here you go.
And that will bring up fourth down for Ole Miss, and the offense has a decision to make. What must be going on in the mind of Lane Kiffin in a critical fourth down situation like this?
What are you waiting for? Throw the fade. Nonsense. Take the field goal. You've left enough points on the field already.
It's only 7 yards. Nothing a little double cross read option slant can't take care of. Call it.
You know, I think that's the field goal kicker's family in the stands. I'm sure they'd like to see their son get a little playing time.
Everyone knows we only answer to the analytics.
Take a look at the fourth down analytic guy's face. He's either not confident about it, or he's very, very constipated. You tell me which one it is.
If you want that LSU money, you've got to take some risks. You've got a Heisman-caliber quarterback.
On a juiced-up, swollen ankle the size of a sourdough loaf.
Ooh, we should put Plumlee in as a decoy.
Yeah, we could just call a double wide receiver reverse pass, throw it into triple coverage, and just see what happens.
Yes,
Now you're on my level. Lane, kick the field goal. It's like a 30-yard field goal. Our kicker's not even that bad. He's like 9 of 11 for the whole year.
Field goals?
I thought this was the Lane train, not the Lane Amtrak Crescent on its last leg from New York where the toilets don't work.
If we don't get this, it will be three. Count them, three red zone turnovers on downs.
Come on! Every picker on College Game Day picked you. But Lane, the guest picker was Ken Jung. Plus, Auburn home night game. You really want to take on that voodoo? Maybe I should just kick it. It's the smart thing to do. Do you remember when Nick Saban would never let you go for it on fourth down? Well, you're calling the shots now. Do it. Come on. Katy Perry could be watching. Let it ride.
And the pass is incomplete. Ole Miss turns it over on downs for the third time tonight in the
What a bummer. Well, at least you know the fans are just going to blame the refs. And hey, if we leave now, we can catch one of those Oreo shakes at Applebee's before they close. Something about
an Applebee's. All right, so that was SEC Shorts, and that was a video that they dropped, I guess, Sunday or Monday.
Oh,
and
my
that was
gosh.
Lane Kiffin with a devil on one shoulder and an angel on the other and debating fourth down and going for it. And the analytics, love it, love it, love it. So we'll see how that continues to look as we roll on through November. If I had to guess, Blake, he's not going to take his foot off the pedal.
No.
Or the accelerator.
He is. What's the old line? We are who they thought they were.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's just, yeah, he's going to do what, I think he's going off analytics, but I think he's going aggressively off analytics. Is that fair to say?
Yeah.
Like the analytics may say.
No, they're Lane's analytics.
Well, that's what I'm saying. The analytics may say it's a 52%, and he's like, it's more than 50, we're
right.
going for it.
Right.
He's right. aggressively pushing him.
We just shared that on our Out of Bounds Facebook page. So you can go to Facebook, search the Out of Bounds Show, and check out that SEC Shorts video on Lane Kiffin. And, hey, they do them on everybody. So no point in getting all huffy and puffy.
No, that one's a good one, though. I mean, because even Ole Miss fans, I think, can look at that and go, that's got to be what's happening.
Sure.
Like Lane's sitting there going, like, it's third.
But the picture, if that was the analytics guy on Saturday night,
it
when
was.
They freeze frame that guy,
yeah.
the look on his face was like,
this is not the right call. Yeah.
I don't think this is what my numbers are telling.
Yeah.
You know.
He, like, glances down at the Waffle House menu that he has in his hand.
Yeah.
And he, like, looks back up at the scoreboard, and you can tell he's doing some math in his head where he's like, wait. Am I reading this right? Are we? And like Kiffin's just not. He's done. He's
yeah.
going for it.
Done.
So I don't. You know. I mean, I get why you're not the better team, so you have to make something happen.
Sure.
So
you're
I
on
get
the.
It.
We talked about that yet. Two things yesterday, right? You're on the road. You're not the better team. You're not the more talented team.
Yeah,
I get it.
And you're not even healthy. Like if they were fully healthy, it might have been different. Like if they
right.
had their receivers running full speed. Maybe you kick
yeah.
a couple field goals because you think we
Drummond
can still score.
Drummond pops a hamstring. Sanders is not healthy. Mingo's
yeah.
not playing. I get it.
Yeah.
I get it. The SEC Insider Hit this morning brought to you by Blue Cross Blue Shield of Mississippi. It's good to be blue. The official healthcare provider of the Out of Bounds Show. Want to welcome you in. Say good morning. Thanks for hanging out with us. We've got a good show lined up for you today. Mike Dettillier at 8:30. Mike D. Straight out of New Orleans, WWL Radio TV New Orleans. 9 a.m., we'll have Jake Mangum, the Hit King, live in the Bank Plus studio. He'll join us for an hour. We're also, what do they have, Blake, 5 minutes to get in on the baseball? All right, we're giving away a Jake Mangum baseball. You can weigh in on any of our topics this morning via the text line. Best text wins an autographed Jake Mangum baseball. Ag Up Equipment text line 601-885-3776. 885-3776. Mike Dettillier at 8:30. Jake Mangum, 9 a.m.